Hello, Kelly here from Root Pursuit. It's a good day to craft today because it is cold outside. It is, I don't know, like -2 or something, but then it feels like, which is the wind chill, it's like essentially -11. So it's cold outside. Nobody wants to go out. The roads were slippery today. I didn't like it, but we've got this fun project to do. And I have this pile here, and it is organized. It may not look organized, but it is. All right, so I am inviting you to come along on my journey to do the full deck challenge. The full deck challenge is where you take cards, dun, dun, dun. You see those? Oop, they're a little high. Bring it back. Bring it back. Ooh, no, my organization. Stay. Okay, so these are the ones I've done so far. I did a video of these, but the video didn't turn out. There was some interruption. Here's my favorite. Look at this one. Ooh, look at that. Ah. Here's my second favorite. Ooh, ah. you don't necessarily have to keep the numbers showing, but I thought it would be fun to do that. This one, obviously, I didn't. Here's another cute one. Ooh. Oh, and another one. These are really similar, actually. Using the same kind of flower from the same pack. So, at any rate, those are the ones I've worked on so far. I did a video. I got interrupted. I threw the video in my trash, in my virtual phone trash. Because, like, what is that? We don't want any. Oh, that's my. Jeez. My hair isn't even that long. Whose hair is that? Jeez. Oh, that's a string from the ribbon. I'm like, my hair's not that long. Thinking it was a hair. Okay, that was weird. Anyway, so we've got these samples. I'm sorry you missed out, but that's okay. We'll do more. This is the hashtag full deck challenge. I learned about it from a Facebook group called Junk Journal Tutorials. I like the group. I hang out in there once in a while, pretty much every day. I check it out, see what people are doing and what they're making. But anyway, I'm just basically gonna make these cards, and I have some supplies that I've kind of organized here. Let's see what we've got. Okay, cards. And now we've got neutral. We've got little scrapples of paper, hello, of stamped, but my goodness, what do you call that? Writing paper. This is actually like a Sears catalog. Scrapple. This is a music page. I could not think of that word. Now I did. Okay, so there's those. I'm gonna move all my sample ones up and out of the way. So I've got my plain papers as an accent. More cards. These are my just little embellishment pieces. That's what we're gonna call those. Those are just random bits of whatever. So we're gonna call those embellishment or accents. Accents, that's a better description. These are my focal points. Yes, they are. Ooh, what's this? Well, that's a card I was gonna do. Okay. Anyway, that's gonna be my first one. So these are my focal points all together. More cards and ooh, scraps, fuzzes, fuzz, fuzz. Can you believe this? It's like I've been crafting. Anyway, here's one I could use. I did that one before. Backgrounds. That's what these are. This is not a background. You're confused. It's a focal point. These should all be backgrounds, but they're not. So much for my organization method. And I'm gonna need more backgrounds than that. I'm just gonna need more. So I'm gonna get some paper down. And these are just smaller pieces of paper. So I think we've got everything. Oh, and I have fabric scraps in here. Fabric scraps, add a little scrap bowl embellishment, and then this one paid stamp, which I got, and I think is really cool. So let's see how it looks. Let's stamp something. Ta-da! How fun is that? Oh, it smells what is that? Like rubber bands. No, not rubber bands. Band-aids. Sheesh. Words, they're hard. Anyway, so I counted out the 52. So between these cards and these cards, we got 52. Full deck challenge, that's what this is called. Hey, why don't you get crafting, Kelly? Okay, I think I will. These are more like accents, these aren't. That's a focal point. More than actual backgrounds. Oh, see, I made another one. Look how cute is that? I hope it's not too wide for one of these. Eight isn't, that's not a great number. It's a boring number. So boring. I could do the red, bottom. See, that's how I do it, I go bright. What's the brightest color I can possibly find, and that's what I do. Oh, that's really cute. Ooh, I have this paper pack that I got. I think I got this on AliExpress. And they're so tiny. They're so cute. And they're very square. So I don't know how that's gonna go. I think I'll put these back because I'm not sure. I think we might lose too much if we use those. Because they're cool on the whole, but not individual-like. Those are kind of bright. Kind of bright. Pretty, though. Ooh. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. My husband's coughing. Hope he doesn't have the Rona. I don't think he does. Alright, otherwise I wouldn't be joking about it, right? That's in poor taste. Oh, okay, this would look good with that. Mayhaps. Should I go this way? Yeah, we're gonna do that. Do it like paper. I like it. So I'm just gonna square it up. Make two. One for the bottom, one for the top. I do like things to be symmetrical. Otherwise, I could have made it so like it was wider on the top. But no, that's not how I roll. That's not it. Oh, see, putting it on here. And then when I'm done crafting, it'll still be there. Nope, because it falls off. This magnet is, well, frankly, just, it seems like a good idea, but then glue gets on there, and also I bump it, and it just doesn't work out, and it makes me sad. Very sad about that. Such a good idea, if only my magnet was strong enough. Maybe I need a little needle pouch. How about that? Hmm. Oh yeah. That's how it's gonna be. All right, I do have a magnet over here, so that's where it's gonna go for now. I have a little, one of those little library catalog card deals. And that's where I keep my ink pads. And I have a little magnet on that side. And then I stick my little metal objects I don't want to lose on there. Mainly my pins for my glue. Okay, that's pretty cute. Got another one done. I could do the corners, but blah, blah. Who needs it? You know, what could be fun is I have like punched out, like punch outs, like that. Okay. No, we need it. We need it to be right side up. Something like that. That could be cool. And then just kind of decorate around the edges, see if I have any different ones. Where I make a decision. I guess I'm making a decision because I don't have any more. I'm not crazy about that. Oh, I don't think that's gonna work. Where's this one? The brown. Maybe. No. Nay. So my son, oh, he turns 17 tomorrow, his favorite expression is bruh. So he'll say, hey bruh, to me, and it's sort of like bro, but bruh, I don't know. Starting to feel like I used to like ironic t-shirts, and I went to go shopping for them and they had some ironic t-shirts, and I didn't think they were like good ironic t-shirts anymore. One had ramen noodles on it and I was like, no, I don't like it. No ramen noodles on your t-shirt. Oh my goodness. Okay, that's all I got. That's all I got. I'm going for it. Hopefully that is wide enough. And then we'll just decorate around that. I'm thinking that will be fun to do. With what? I have no idea. Something maybe to go with heart. Oh my gosh. Hand eye coordination. That was not a good example of it. Oh my goodness. So, wait. Okay. No. These are focal points. Oh, I put those in the wrong pile. Focal points. Accent. Focal points. Get them all mixed up. Alright, I'm gonna tear that off. I'm gonna go this way. Maybe some music notes. Oh, that says all the day long. What? Hold on. Now I don't know what to do. Hmm. It's true. I was crafting about my channel. I got some green ink on my fingernail. The truth is out. I've been crafting without you. Alright, let's do not brushed quarter. Vintage photo. How about that? And we need one of these deals. Okay, we got one little schmittle. We got a ways to go. So I was gonna do this Randall. Like, I was just gonna be like, okay, whatever I pick out, it's going on there. But right now I'm looking for red. Ooh, red rose. Hello. Maybe if I ink all in the same color, I'll help bring all this together. That's what I'm going for. Unification. I'm dropping stuff. Okay, so I really need to make some books. Because I've made like 1,000 pieces of journal cards, tags, and notepads to go in journals. But now I need to get cracking on a little sponge piece. Get cracking on getting some journals made. Get my supplies out of here so I can get new supplies. I mean... I meant. Oh goodness. Truth hurts. Ooh, which side do I like better? This side. Yes. Because that side says decaf and this side says love in every cup. So, whew. Well, I didn't ink that well on that side. Not as good as I could, huh? So I'll just do some cheater inking. Phrase coined by Pam at the Paper Outpost. Cannot take credit for that. There we go. I just need a little tiny bit up there. This is actually going a lot faster now that I have my system here with my piles. I do want to do one where I just pick random from each pile and say, all of this has to go on one card and I have to make it look cohesive. So we'll see how that goes. All right. What do you think? Good? Good. Okay. Done with that. What do we have now? Three of clubs. See if I can still shuffle. See, when you have cards, you just, you have to shuffle them. It's a requirement. So, blown scraps. I can still shuffle. Good. And do my bridge. Okay. Oh, now we're going to have to highlight the club. Just kidding. We're not, are we doing that? Oof. Oof. Does look kind of good. Could do it off center. That would be crazy. I'm gonna do it. Try it. Stop me. Okay. Done that. Now we're gonna tear it crooked. That's what we're gonna do. It's gonna be a little crooked. Okay, here we go. Oh, could have done black. Seems like it's gonna be a black and red kind of a day. We're definitely gonna have to do some where we cover up the whole card. That's gonna happen. Okay, now what? Something. If I put anything on here, it's gotta be kinda neutral-ish. Okay, there's no way that's gonna, well. Okay. That could work. That could be a thing. We're gonna ink this because I feel like my little sponge is just falling apart. Okay, we're gonna ink it because we got a lot of white around the edges. We don't want it. It's not gonna work. It's not gonna match. We're gonna get rid of the white on the inside. That little chair rung is hanging by a thread. Okay, we're gonna need some paper of some kind. Sort of make all this look, you know. These are the tough decisions in life that you have to make. Okay. And now I feel like I'm going through this paper really fast. Okay, so if I put this here, how much of a big of a piece do I need right there? have a feeling I'm gonna cut that edge off of that chair. I suppose I didn't have to cut that off, but I'm just gonna do it. We're just gonna do it. Hammer hangs everywhere. Okay, so this is what we look like so far. We're gonna use our matte super heavy gel matte medium. So the reason I'm using this, I'm taking a little bit of it, and this chair was a high gloss, so I'm just rubbing it over there, and that will make that more of a matte finish instead of a high gloss finish, and that will help everything just sort of blend in a little bit better. Okay, so now I need more to this one. This is, I feel like it's not quite complete. It needs something else. But what? Maybe a word or a phrase. Coming across somewhere. I have lots of genealogy related words. I got woodwren. Okay. Do game of. That's kind of cool. Okay. So I can do it there. I can do it here. Do it here. Ooh. Do it here. The only place I like it is in the place where I can't get it to stick. I can get into. I like that, but then I still need something up here, which probably will not be another letter. So I'll put that away for now. Could do a circle. Thank you. Okay. Well, I guess I'm just having trouble deciding. Trimming off a little bit of the edge. Another deal. Maybe if I pull up my black. Okay, so I have this little piece, but I think I'm gonna highlight it in black around the edges, make it stand out a little better. Hopefully. And also this. The note. Then this little accent piece. All right, here we go. Black. Alright. Okay, that one took a little while, but we got it. Okay. So now let's do another one. Get the four hearts. Now this is where I'm gonna try to do the thing where I randomly pick some items. I'm not looking. I'm gonna pick two accents and one focal and see what we come up with. Oh wow. Interesting. That's kind of cool. So it says the seahorse can anchor itself with its tail. So we can definitely use that somewhere in here. And we can make this a little narrower. Nope, we're going for the torn look. That's what we're gonna do. Sorry, little seahorse. Actually, get rid of some of this blue. And then we'll have more room for our accent pieces. There we go. All right, so now Yep. Okay. We're doing maybe book pages. Not a tearing ruler. That's okay. Just need to get it a little bit close. Okay, move this down. Who knows? We may not need that corner at all. There we go. Book pages. Okay, I think that's what I'm gonna do. A little more ink. Oh, I even had another side to choose from. Didn't even realize it. Okay. I'm gonna ink this because there's not much white in there anyway. Collage deal going on here. Make sure I've got that word twinkle showing. Okay, now I'm gonna ink around this. Okay, I'm thinking I kind of want this to be pink. I'm using this, whatever this is, Victorian velvet. And I'm just gonna. I want it to contrast a little bit with the other book pages. And now I'll just ink around it with the brown. Hopefully that will work. This way, no. Oh my goodness. I don't know. Oh, I know. So if any of you were out there thinking, why don't you just cut it in half up? It must have gotten through eventually. Oh my goodness. There we go. A little crooked. Perfect. Now I'm liking it. Okay, so now I'm just going to trim some of these edges. And then add a little bit more ink and go around all the edges. Okay. There we go. Seahorses. Nice. See, now I wouldn't have thought to put those together, and it looks quite good. I don't know, maybe we should do it again. Let's do random. Okay, random one and two, or four. Whoops. Okay, oh, interesting. I've got this, like, picture of the blocks. Okay. What I think I'll do is cut out the background on this. There. All right. Let's just start gluing and see what happens. Glue's coming out a bit fast. Gonna show it to you, but okay. So that's what we have so far. This is supposed to look like a stamp, but that edge looks a little funky to me. I'm so quiet now. No talking, just crafting. Oh. Something else. Like, I don't know why I'm doing so much black today, but I guess that's what's gonna happen. Little puffy paints. And these are not like liquid pearls. 'Cause That one kind of was, but. All right, I'm gonna get out my black. Just highlight around that a little. That stand out a bit, and then maybe a word. I have my words out. And the ready. Go. It's a little glossy. Let me get my mat and just do that background a bit. And yes, I did. I do have green paint in my bucket. I was doing a project, and no, it's not mold. Don't be scared. It's not mold. Hopefully that just tones that high gloss down a little bit. There. There we go. All right. Well, I'm digging the whole miscellaneous, but this time I'm gonna put my pile a little more evenly. And then I'm going to, oh, I was going to do this mushroom one too. Let me do that one. I need like a background. I think the green could be good. Cover it totally up. Maybe a little butterfly. I've got some butterflies in here somewhere. Do a big butterfly. No, too big. Too much. So you could do like that kind of a deal. Get a circle one. Let me find that one. Here we go. I don't know. This is a true scrap. I didn't use that piece, but that's okay. Maybe that would look good with my mushroom. It'll work. But we are going to have to do some inking. Bring it all together. Have a little less of this, I think. No, it is not straight by any imagination. Do I want that over the top of that? Yeah, I do. Yes, that is a very bright piece. Now this is a washi tape. Oh, wrong one. I don't know that I've ever tried to ink one of these before, but we are today. And I'll just peel that off. I can get it. Oh my goodness. Okay. So then that right here, ooh, that's really hard to see. Kind of disappeared there. Okay. Make sure that stays down. There's not really much hanging over. Ink up our edges. And that's what we've got. And maybe I think I'm gonna do a little. I'm gonna use my script, stamp over the edges a little bit. There we go. Color done. Yeah, I like that one. Things I just normally would not put together necessarily, and it just kind of forces you to bring them together. All right, here we go again. What should we do? missing. And two things. Okay. Okay, card. Ooh, a joker. Okay, so we've got this. Got this. Well, now my magnet totally came off. So much for that. Yeah, I kind of like that, with that edge kind of showing through there. And this can go here. Beauty word. Get that one out. Need some glue on that. I haven't used any of my fabrics or ribbon or anything like that so far. So maybe we should get cracking on that. Okay, now, where are my, put them away. I didn't use any brands or anything on here. This is going to take some time. These are my sticker jewels. Oop, upside down. I'm going to see if I can put some of my oldest ones. This is what I was thinking of. This one right there. Right on top of there. Calling that one done, I think. Let me see here. Ooh, it's a long one. Okay. All right. Well, I hope you have enjoyed coming along. We've made quite a few of these, and I think that will probably do it. Let's just do a little rundown reminder of the ones we did. And here they are. Okay. I got more done. On my way to getting the whole deck done. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 more done. All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed this, and let's do this again. All right, talk to you later.